गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग एक्सरसाइज नंबर 20. दैट इज ऑलरेडी गोइंग ऑन. सम सम्स आर लेफ्ट ऑफ दैट एक्सरसाइज. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस दोस. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज देयर. सो व्हाट कंसेप्ट इज गिवन इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. द ग्रीन लाइट ऑफ अ क्रॉसिंग. सो देयर इज अ क्रॉसिंग एंड देयर इज अ ग्रीन लाइट. इट गोज ऑन एंड ऑफ एवरी 15 सेकेंड्स. एंड देयर इज अ नेक्स्ट क्रॉसिंग and whose light goes on and off after every 20 seconds. If suppose both the lights were lighted at 4 a.m. in the morning, when will they again go on together? So this is like that. There is a crossing number 1 and there is a crossing number 2. Suppose this light goes after 12 minutes and this light goes after 16 minutes. Suppose they have light gone on at 4 a.m. in the morning. Suppose that means next it will go on to at 24 minute. 12 2s are 24, 12 3s are 36, 12 4s are 48. It will go on at 12 minute, 24 minute of a hour, 36 minute of a hour, 48 minute of a hour. And here it is, it will on at 32 minute of a hour and 48 minute of a hour. That means when there is a 48th minute of a hour, both the lights, they will be in on state. So what is this? This is the least common multiple of 12 and 16. And you will add 48 to this. 4:48 a.m. both the lights will be in the on position. Same way you have to calculate. So light of first crossing, light of first crossing goes on after 15 seconds. Light of second crossing goes on after 20 seconds. So find LCM of 20 second and 15 second. So how you can find the LCM? It's very easy. Find the factors of 20. Find the factors of 15. So write the factors of 20. 2 multiply 5 multiply 1. Write the factors of 15. 5 into 3 into 1. So what is the LCM? You will take every factor with the maximum number of times. 5 is there. So 2 is there, maximum number of time 2. And 3 is maximum number 1. Like this. So we will take each and every factor but with the maximum number of times. Either it's appearing in this number or either it's appearing in this number. 20 into 3, that is 60 seconds. So the LCM is 60 seconds. 60 seconds. So 60 seconds means 1 minute. Okay. So if the two lights will go on at 4 a.m. plus 1 minute. So it would be 4:01 a.m. So this is the answer. There are three bells. One ring after every 6 minute, one ring after every 8 minute, and one ring after every 10 minute. Suppose they have ring together in the morning at 6 a.m. When will they ring together? We will find the LCM of both the 3 minutes, of all the 3 minutes, and that would be the same time when all the bells will ring together. Like first bell rang after 6 minutes. So this is question number 9. Second bell rang after 8 minutes. Third bell rang after 10 minutes. Find LCM of 6 minutes, 8 minutes, and 10 minutes. So find the factors of 6, find the factors of 2. Prime factors you have to find 2, 5, 1. So 6 is equal to 2 into 3 into 1. 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. 10 is equal to 2 into 5. What is the LCM? So LCM is 2 comes in every maximum number of times we will take 2. 3 will come in one factor, that doesn't concern us, we have to take maximum number of times. And 5. I have already told you how to calculate the LCM. 4, 8 into 15. So 15, 8 the 40, 4, 8, 1, 2, 120. Okay, that is 120. 120 minute. So after 120 minute, all the three bells will ring together. So three bells will ring together at, will ring, not ring, will ring together at 6:00 a.m. plus 120 minute means 2 hour. So that would be 8:00 a.m. So this is the answer. Question number 10. We have to find the greatest number that will divide 61, 94 and 140. But when it divides 60, 94, 140, it will leave some remainders, leaving 1, 4 and 5 respectively. So when that number divides 61, it will leave remainder 1. When that number, maximum number, that divides 94, it will leave the remainder 4. When that maximum number divides 140, it will leave the remainder 5. For example, there is a 7. Is 2 divided 7? No. So what is the remainder? 1. That means 7 is not divided by 2. If we minus the remainder from 7, that is divided by the 2. Okay, so minus this remainder, that means 61 is not divided by that highest number. What is being divided? 60 is being divided by that highest number. 94 is not divided by that number, that means 90 is divided by that number. 140 is not divided by that number, 135 is divided by that number. So target is to find HCF of highest common factor, that means highest number that divides this number also, this number also, this number also. That will divide this number, but it will not divide 61. When suppose 20 divides this number, but 20 will not divide this number. When 20 divides this number, then 1 will come as a remainder. So HCF of 60, 90 and 135. We can go for common division method also. So we can go on the table of 5, 12, 18 and 135 means 10 means 2, 7, 27. It can go on the table of 3 also, 4, 3 is 12, 6, 3 is 18, like this. So what is the HCF? HCF is 5 multiplied 3. So 15 is the HCF. So 15 is the number, maximum number, that divides this number also, this number also, this number also. So 15 is the maximum number, it will divide this number also, but it will leave remainder 1. 15 is the maximum number, it will divide 94 also, but it will leave 4 as a remainder. 15 is the maximum number, that divides 140 also, but it will leave 5 as a remainder. So this is nothing. They have given some numbers. They are not actually divided by the highest number that we are looking for, but they are leaving some remainders. So we have to find the actual numbers that have been divided by that highest number. So these are the numbers. So if there are three numbers, the highest factor of all the three numbers is HCF. So our target is to find HCF. HCF divides 60 properly, but it will not divide 61, it will leave 1 as remainder. HCF divides 90 properly, but it will, when it is divided by 94, it will leave 4 as a remainder. This is sure.
Thank you.
So the last question is, find the least number which when divided by 20, 24, 32. So there are three numbers. So you will be finding a number. 20 will also divide that number. 24 will also divide that number. And 32 will also divide that number. But always 5 will be the remainder. This you can take as the same example like that. Suppose there is a 48 is a number. Okay, 48 is a number. It is divided by 12 also. It is divided by 16 also. Okay, it is divided by 12 also and 16 also. But always leaves a remainder. Suppose you can say 5 as a remainder. Then that number is 48 plus 5, that is 53. When you divide 53 by 12, na, you are going to get 4 and 5 is a remainder. And when you divide 53 by 16, this is the least number. So this is the LCM of this 12 and 16. So there are three numbers, you know, 20, 24 and 32. We will find the LCM of both the numbers and then we add the remainder to that number. Then we are getting, then our target of obtaining the least number will be obtained. Step number one, find the LCM. So in order to find the LCM, it is very easy. Short division method you can use. It goes on the table of 2, 10, 12, and 16. Again 2, 5, 6, 8. Goes on the 5, 1, 6, 8. 2, 3, 4. 3, it goes on the table of 4, 1, 1, and 1. So LCM is 2, 2 is a 4. 5, 4 is a 20, 22 is a 40, 43 is a 120, 120 into 4, 480. So this is the LCM. So 480 is, but 480 is the, not the number. Because 480 is exactly divided by 20 also, exactly divided by 24 also, 32 also, and this is the least number that is divided by this, this and this. But our target is not. They are saying the number is like that. When 20 divides that number, 24 divides that number, 30, always 5 comes a remainder. So the number is not 480, the number is 485. So this is the answer. Thank you. Have a nice day.